The Captain Black Master trying the new Danish Captain Black, and he's going to compare it to the original. If you hate it, be truthful. If you love it, be truthful. He's smoking in a, is it the J. Mouton Morta?
Yeah.
J. Mouton Morta. Don't get much better than a J. Mouton.
Want the review?
Yeah, man. I want to hear it.
This actually tastes a lot closer to Captain Black that I enjoy. I had it previously in a different pipe, but I'm not used to smoking Captain Black in. And it tasted like 5 to 10% of what I was expecting in terms of its similarity to the classic Captain Black. And I'd still say it's more mild than the traditional Captain Black.
Okay.
Hard to say how much more mild right now, but I think quite a bit more mild. The original Captain Black is very flavorful. It's very sweet. And, you know, it's very bold. And this is not as strong of a flavor, much more mild of a flavor. Uh-huh. Same flavors, I think. But the original Captain Black is like candy because it's so strong and sweet. And this is there, but it's not the same thing to me. This is the first time I'm trying it, so.
Yeah.
I think maybe, you know, this is just one experience, could be different on a different night, but yeah. Final thoughts on the new Captain Black. It's a lot like the old Captain Black.
Okay.
I feel like it's milder, but the same flavor profile is there. I couldn't pick out any distinct changes. You know, it's pretty solid, pretty good, but much more mild.
Okay.
Than the original Captain Black. So maybe you like that. I don't know. But it did seem a little different just in terms of power. But overall, it's good stuff.
Well, good to see you again, guys. I hope you enjoyed. That little homage to my very best friend. And it goes by Hondo on here. Now, he doesn't have a channel or anything, but he's graceful enough to, or I should say, gracious enough to come up here and hang out with me. Unfortunately, it's just been once a year. That's better than nothing, though. And put up with me filming him a little bit on different occasions. And for my new subscribers, I'll tell you a little bit of the backstory. He and I literally grew up together. He is my oldest continual friend. I consider him my brother. Matter of fact, we call him Uncle for my son. Our relationship has gone through turmoil, don't get me wrong. And ups and downs. But the very unique thing about our friendship is that it's always endured. It's always endured across oceans, across the world. We never weren't friends. You know, we were always friends. And for Christmas this year, I found a pocket watch, and I got it engraved with his initials, and then also on the back it said, "Not even time can stop true friendship." And so, anyway, we had a great weekend that he came up, and I'm gonna tell you a little antics of his antics, because it's never a dull moment when he comes up, and then I'll tell you his of how he truly is a codger in the essential sense of the word. So you have to understand that my friend, he's always a little late, and he's always got something going on, right? And I usually think that the things and the things that he has will be up to the task at hand. Whereas my wife sometimes will say, maybe not. Well, he had purchased a truck a while back, and my friend's farm, which you guys have seen me film up there a little bit, we go up there, and I said, hey, you know, when you come up, why don't we just meet up there? We'll do a little shoot and hang out, and then we'll head back here and get some lunch. So he was like, yeah, you know, I can do that. I'm gonna see another guy up in Louisville. So shameless plug to Corvette Gym there. But anyway, but it had been, I mean, here in the Kentuckiana region, we got super sub-zero temperatures over the holiday. And I mean, great, it was wonderful, snow, beautiful in my opinion, but it's a pretty steep hill to get up to the farm. And I have four-wheel drive here, that's right there. And I load down the truck. Oh, I knew that. Yeah.
You can tell how wiggly it is.
Oh, yeah. He wasn't going to. Yeah. So, anyway, I also load down the back of my truck with sandbags. I'm going to put the camera on you. My wife's dancing. Watch it. She's getting filmed. The threatening. Say hi, Mrs. Paladin.
Hi, Mrs. Paladin.
So anyway, and he now resides in Florida, so he doesn't. Oh yeah, she's in here for the I told you so moment. So so he only has, which I thought he had a four wheel drive truck.
Watch yourself.
He only has rear wheel drive truck. And he does not have anything in the back of his truck. He had a set of weights that I think it totaled about 60 pounds, weights I had given him years ago. So he didn't have enough weight. So I get a phone call, and he's like, hey man, I'm stuck on the hill. And I'm like, okay. I'm like, do you think you can push through? He's like, every time I hit the gas, wheels start spinning, I go down backwards. I'm like, oh shit, okay. So it's about a quarter of a mile walk down to the bottom, and he's about about two-thirds of the way up the hill, but he's got the steepest part to still get through, I should say. And therein starts the fun. He tried everything. We tried, you know, throwing sticks underneath, and we, you know, we just weren't gonna get enough purchase. So in our grand design idea, we thought, all right, well, we're going to back down the hill. Well, the hill is really kind of curvy, right? So as he's backing down the hill, of course, you're sliding on ice, so he can't control his vehicle. He gets off stuck in the ditch. And it took us about an hour and a half to dig him out of that ditch. And then we finally just coasted him down. And by the grace of God and a little bit of luck, we got down without him smashing his truck into a tree. So So then we just hiked up the top to the farm. We walked up, did a little shooting, and then we all got together, had a little bit of snacks that we brought, and then I drove down to the bottom, dropped him off at the car, at his truck, and then he followed us home. So anyway, of course, when he was over here, I had said to him, "Dude, you gotta try the new Captain Black. Because you gotta understand something about my buddy. He is Captain Black White. He is the, as I put on this video, he is the godfather of Captain Black White. Nothing is better than Captain Black White. The only thing that's come close is I sent him the remaining part of that Ivan Reese, three-star banner, which of all of their blends is kind of like Captain Black White. So I was like, dude, you got to try the Danish version, because I think the Danish version is better than the Tucker Georgia version, which I have to say, you know, with the Danish versions of some of these blends, I didn't initially like them as much. They kind of grown on me now. And again, I'm still got plenty of the Tucker Georgia stuff, so I'm gonna smoke through all that. But you know, especially like half and half, which we'll get to that in a second. You know, half and half is pretty darn good. You know, the Velvet, I have to say, Velvet now, they took it back a few, so I like that profile better than I do with the Tucker Georgia. Doesn't mean I'm not gonna not smoke the Velvet, but as you guys, if you've been with me for any length of time, you know I bounce pretty much between 5 Codger blends. I mean, that's pretty much what I smoke all the time. Don't get me wrong, I have an English, you know, I'm gonna go through my some of my boutique blends and things like that, but pretty much I'm going back to my 5 staples, which is Edward G. Robinson, Half and Half, Sir Walter Raleigh, Velvet, and Prince Albert. Granger and Prince Albert kind of go in an interchangeably, so 5 or 6. But anyway, so that's what you saw, was his take on the new Cab Black. And he's such a codger that he's like, I don't know. Like when the camera went off, he's like, no. He's like, it's not the same. I don't like it. I'm like, so I asked him, like, do you have enough of the Tucker Georgia stuff? And he's like, oh yeah, man. He's like, I got it. Cause I sent him a tub. And then that was like one of those 16-ounce tubs, you know? And then he got a big bag of it, he said. And he was like, yeah, I got enough, yeah. But an example of his life is truly a codger way of life. I mean, he's just a simple man. He doesn't need a lot of things. He never did, even when we were growing up. He doesn't need the newest whatever. He doesn't need the highest falutin tool or coat or whatever. He's very content. You know, and it's something that I've always admired about him, and I hope he watches this video, because I know he watches some, but I have admired that about him, because a lot of us get wrapped up in worldly things that don't mean anything, you know, and you know he takes solace in the fact that he smokes that J. Mouton Mortar, which I purchased for him as a gift, and he smokes the hell out of it. And that's another thing. He had like a dime's worth of cake, maybe even more than that, maybe 2 dimes worth of cake in that J. Mouton's Morta. And I was like, oh my God, we're going to have to read that out. So he had to like scrub it out, you know. But that's what he smokes. He smokes that Captain Black White, you know, and he's happy. And he's truly happy, you know. And that's a codger. So. Anyway, all right, so way more than 11 minutes in this segment, but if you guys are new to my channel, whenever you see this pipe, now I've got a couple of clones of this pipe, but they're a little bit smaller bowls, so I'll kind of show you the billiard. This is my favorite pipe. I mean, it is. It's the one that I grab the most. I don't know why I gravitated to this so early on in the game. Probably the yellow stem, which is just something I like yellow anyway in the contrast. But anyway, I started smoking half and half out of it pretty early on, and half sung in its pipe from the day that I put it in there. And then I kind of gradually transitioned to doing half and half in Sir Walter Raleigh mixed, which is what I've dubbed Codger Corner. It's probably been named some 10 million other things, but I call it Codger Corner. And so this is my Codger Corner pipe. So this is half and half in Sir Walter Raleigh, or sometimes I will just put half and half in it if I'm just, you know, one half and half. And so I've got Codger Corner in there tonight. But I got a package today. And a package that I was not anticipating. Now, Matthew from Picking and Piping, and I'll put his link, I'll put both these guys' links in the description for you, and I hope you will check them out and give them a look. Matthew from Picking and Piping does every year, he does a Secret Santa. And I didn't do it last year, but I thought, you know what, I wanted to do it this year mainly to give. And I'm going to do more giveaways, I'm going to send more stuff out to people because I think that's what our calling is here on Earth, or at least part of it, is just to be good people. And so anyway, so I signed up for it. And I, to be quite honest with you, I didn't really want anything. I don't need anything. I'm always appreciative of the things that are sent to me and gifts and things like that. But I've been very blessed and I wanted to give back. That's why I did it. I get a package today from an address that I am familiar with. And that is from none other than Swaggy Man Piper, 1926. So his link will be in the bucket too. Great guy. Will is a wonderful guy. Salt of the earth man. You can totally tell that. One day, brother, we will have a pipe together. And I open up said box, and I'm going to save you that part. But inside said box, let me get relit with my Codger Corner here. Inside said box was this. Now, you know the way to my heart, Will. Yeah. Awesome. Love it. Thank you. I cannot thank you enough. Couldn't have gotten me anything better, to be honest with you. But wait, there's more. This was not necessary. Not necessary at all, this next part. So this is a Missouri Meerschaum egg, I believe, with an emerald stem, an acrylic stem. Unsmoked cob. And I tell you what, guys, if you have been on the fence about Codger blends, well, Buddy Hondo would tell you, get off your ass and try Captain Black White. And I'll say, yeah, try to. I mean, you know. But seriously, try your first slew of Codger blends in a cob. How do I say this? They act differently in a cob. I really think that most of them were meant for corn cob pipes. So much so that I almost dedicated, because it was so sweet, it was so good, and had I not just ghosted the living heck out of this, one of my Missouri Prides for my half and half Sir Walter Raleigh, my Codger Corner mix, because it's so sweet, in a cob. And the thing is that even if you buy a tub, you know, and I'm not sure how much Will paid for this, if he got it at brick and mortar or if he got it online. I think, I'm pretty sure as of the recording of this video, you know, the half and half tubs here are like $16, maybe 20, depending on where you get it. I know Velvet has always been around 20, which I find interesting because sometimes, well, a lot of times I've seen the half and half will sell out quicker. Sir Walter Raleigh can be sometimes like $26. But so it's not going to break your bank. And if you hate it, it's popular enough to where someone will like it, like me. So you could always trade. So that is going to wrap up my really long video. I hope you're still with me here at the end. Got some more good stuff coming up, and I'm going to try a whole bunch of blends that Average John sent me, and Parsimonious Piper sent me, so they're coming on the channel. I did finally get the, I'll give you a little teaser. There was a partnership with SM Frank and Camoys, and that's very interesting. I found out some cool stuff on that. I'm going to show you some pipes and some stuff like that and tell you the history of that. That's coming up soon on the channel. I love all things SM Frank. They're the company that made Yellow Bull, Medico, and K-Woody, and still do. So, all right. But until next time, we'll see you again very soon. Take care, guys.